Well, good evening everyone. My name is Elsie Normington and I want to give you a very warm welcome tonight to Singing for Pleasure. We are a community singing group and we meet in the Merkinch Community Centre every Tuesday night down there in the community of Merkinch. And of course we're doing online sessions during the lockdown. So there's a few people up already. There's Phyllis and Norma. Good evening ladies, it's nice to see you. So we love to just have a good time singing all our old favourites and generally enjoying a nice sing-along when we all meet together. And there's Andrew, lovely to see you there Andrew, and Phyllis joining. So we're going to start with our wee warm-ups and we usually just do a little bit of humming. Let's try it. Let's try it again. There's more people joining. We've got Elspeth and there's Chrissy and Margaret and Carol and Helen Monroe. Lovely to see you all, ladies. So we're going to do a few little scales just to warm up these vocal cords and then we'll get started. So tonight we've got a nice Broadway theme. So here we go. Are we all set? La 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 la. La 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 la. That's our wee warm up there. And there's Ian Cameron. Good evening, Ian and Morna. Lovely to see you. And Anne McCready. And it's great to see you. And there's Kay McKenzie. Lovely that you've all joined us. Well, tonight we're going to do a right old-fashioned belter. I love to do these old songs and just keep them alive, really. That's what I like to do. And so this song that we're going to sing, the Alexander Brothers used to sing it, but you know, we've made it our own. We've got our very own version. So if you're following in the book tonight, it's number 54, and we're going to sing Doon in the Wee Room, Underneath the Stair. And there's Effie. Good evening, Effie, joining us. So here we go. Doon in the Wee Room, page 54. Doon in the wee room, underneath the stair. Everybody's happy, everybody's there. And we're all back in Mary, each in our chairs. Doon in the wee room, underneath the stair. Now, maybe your living room's not underneath the stair, but you know, we're all in our own living rooms. Who else have we got there? There's Cindy and Pat. Lovely to see you, ladies. But we're all sitting in our living rooms and maybe you're sitting there on your own and I want you to know that we care about you tonight and I hope you feel that sense of being connected to Singing for Pleasure. So we're going to do that again, Doon in the Wee Room. You might want to clap along, you might want to toe tap along because it's a great rhythm and we'll go right through the song. So here it comes. Doon in the wee room, underneath the stair. Singing for pleasure there. Every Tuesday evening, come thunder or come fair, do not bid the fairy, you're sure to find us there. Cause it's doing in the wee room, underneath the stair. Everybody's happy, everybody's there. And we're all back in Mary, each in the chair. Doing in the wee room, underneath. All else has got us happy, singing without care, sometimes even dancing, letting down our hair. was a great wee number, wasn't it? And it really gets you going, sure it does. And I love that line, we're all Mac and Mary, each in his chair. So I really hope that's brought a wee smile to your face tonight. And there's a few more folk joined us. Norma Gall, good evening. Norma, it's lovely to see you. So yeah, I think singing is such a powerful antidepressant, really. It can really lift your spirit, and lyrics can make you laugh, they can make you be reflective, it can have all kinds of emotional effects. But you know, it's a great thing to have a bit of comedy and humour, isn't it? And it causes us to laugh. So there you go, that was Dune in the Wee Room Underneath the Stair. Now then, okay, we're now going to do a very different style now, and this is a more modern style. This is a song by ABBA, I Have a Dream. Now, Anne McSween, if you're watching, I know that you love this song, and if you're there with Chrissy tonight, you'll be glad that we're going to sing this, because you often ask it as a favourite. So I have a dream. You know, we all have dreams of some kind or other. And as you know, I've got quite a big dream to see the Haven built one day. And it's important to hold on to your dreams and believe that they'll come true. So here we go. I have a dream. It's page 84. Yeah, page 84. Right, I think we're all set. Yeah. I'm going to start that again. I've not quite got the right setting. And again. I have a dream, a song to sing, to help me cope with anything. If you see the dream. And as you all know, I've got this big dream to build the Haven Centre. If you already know, we've raised half of the money, just over half the money, over 2 million, and we've to raise another 2 million. And I'm asking the Scottish Government to help us. So if you're able to, if you're watching tonight, I would be so grateful if you could write to some of the MSPs and ask them to support the Haven, because we need a really big grant now so we can move forward and then be able to start building this wonderful centre for our most severely disabled children in the Highlands, the Haven Centre. So that's my dream.
Now then, we're going on again to another jolly song this time. And this song was made very famous by Cliff Richard. Now, I know some of you are big fans of Cliff. He's been a great singer, hasn't he? Singing all these decades, and he still looks quite young too. So we're going to sing Congratulations and Celebrations. And this one is number 46 in your book, Congratulations and Celebrations. Here we go. Right, we're all set.
Congratulations and celebrations when I tell everyone that you're in love with me. Congratulations and jubilations, I want the world to know I'm happy as can be. Who would believe that I can be happy and contented? I used to think that happiness hadn't been invented, but that was in the bad old days before I met you. Oh, when I let you walk into my heart. Congratulations and celebrations when I tell everyone that you're in love with me. Congratulations and jubilations, I want the world to know I'm happy as can be. I was afraid that maybe you thought you were above me, that I was only fooling myself to think you'd love me. But then tonight you said you couldn't be without me, and drank to prompt me, you want to stay. And celebrations when I tell everyone that you're in love with me. Congratulations and jubilations, I want the world to know I'm happy as can be.
We'll sing the chorus again.
Congratulations and celebrations when I tell everyone that you're in love with me. Congratulations and jubilations, I want the world to know I'm happy as can be. I want the world to know I'm happy as can be. Can be, can be.
Well, there we go. I'm sure that brings back memories when you were a youngster and a teenager and remembering Cliff Richard and all the young people screaming for him. I guess it just shows their age, doesn't it? But anyway, great old songs and nice to keep them all alive. Now then, okay, a nice wee bit of Scotland. We always like to have a little taste of Scotland. So tonight we're going to sing number 212. Who have we got here? Oh, there's Helen McLeod. That's nice. Christine Diagnosti's watching. Lovely to see you. And there's Norman Walker as well. Good evening, everybody. Lovely to see you all. And welcome to our Singing for Pleasure group. So we're going to sing Will You Go, Lassie Go. There we go. A nice wee Scottish number.
Oh, the summer time is coming, and the trees are sweetly blooming, and the wild mountain time rolls around the blooming heather. Will ye go, lassie, go? I will build my love a bower near your pure crystal fountains, and on it I will pile all the go, lassie, go. My true love, she were gone, I would surely find another where wild mountain thyme grows around the blooming heather. Will ye go, lassie, go?
Nice wee song. It's a great old favourite, isn't it? As I say, I like to keep all the old favourites alive. And just while I'm talking about old favourites, I do a little session on a Tuesday morning for people with learning disabilities. So if you know anyone in that category, Tuesday morning at 10:30, we do the Rainbow Singers. And also on a Thursday evening at 8:00, I do Take 20, which is 20 minutes of gospel songs and sayings. So if you like the old-fashioned gospel songs, that's the session to join. So there we go. Now then, another great song from The Sound of Music. Now, sometimes my dear friend Richard Sided, he has asked for this one in Singing for Pleasure. And listen, Richard, if you're watching tonight, I just want to say happy birthday to Richard because it's his birthday today. And I hope you've had a good day, Richard. So we're going to do Raindrops and Roses. And this is specially for you, but we'll all accompany you as well. So, of course, this is famous from The Sound of Music and Julie Andrews, that wonderful voice of Julie Andrews singing to all Captain Bontrap's children, Raindrops on Roses. So it's number 144 in your books if you're following along. So here we go, Raindrops on Roses. Here it comes.
Raindrops on roses and whiskers on thistles, dry copper kettles and warm woolen mittens, brown paper packages tied up with strings. These are a few of my favourite things. Cream-coloured ponies and crisp apple strudel, doorbells and sleigh bells and schnitzel with noodles, wabbies that fly with
number that, isn't it? You know, all the things that can make us smile and laugh, isn't it? I think we'll do it again, actually. Although the first time was for you, Richard, we're all going to do it again. You need a lot of breath for that, and that's very, very good for us. You know, oftentimes people's respiratory system can improve through singing. And so I encourage you all to sing every day. You know, sing in the shower, sing when you're washing the dishes. You know, I often have a wee sing to myself when I'm walking Daisy along the lane and nobody hears me and I just sing along. It's a good thing because it lifts your spirits. So let's do Raindrops and Roses again for a second time. It's worth it, isn't it? Here it comes. Songs. You know, years back I used to do a lot of life coaching, and one of the strategies that I used to use when I was talking to people, especially if they were very down and downhearted and just feeling like their life was going nowhere and there's nothing good in their life, I used to say, look, I'm going to ask you to start a little journal, and in that journal I want you to have an attitude of gratitude. And so it was all about writing the favourite things, if you like, the things that we're thankful for, write them down. And you know, very quickly, it was fascinating how people would come back to the next coaching session and they had lots and lots of things to be thankful for. And often it can give us a new perspective on our lives when we have that attitude of gratitude. So there you go. That was my favourite things. Great stuff. Now then, here we go. I imagine that we're nearly at the end of the session already. So we're going to finish tonight with, again, an old favourite. We've sung this a couple of times over the lockdown period, but we're going to do it again. It's page 106 in your books, and we're going to sing Let There Be Peace on Earth. Because even although we're easing out of the lockdown, you know, there's still a lot of unrest, there's still a lot of concern, a lot of anxiety, isn't there? And, you know, different countries and what they're saying and doing and all the rest of it. And it's so important that we all find that inner place of peace. And so, let there be peace on earth. And I encourage you that as you sing this, just to have an attitude of peace in your heart and in your mind as we sing it. It's a beautiful song. This song is actually written for an international school choir, and it's become a famous song that many choirs have actually sang this all over the world. Let there be peace on earth.
Let there be peace on earth, and let it begin with me. Let there be peace on earth, the peace that was meant to be with God as a Father. let this be the moment now. With every step I take, let this be my solemn vow, to take each moment and live each moment in peace.
A great note to finish off, isn't it? Let there be peace on earth and let it begin with me, because all of us can be peacemakers. All of us can bring that little seed of peace into the world. Well, I just want to say thank you very much for watching tonight. Thank you for logging in. I hope it's lifted your spirits tonight, and until we meet again, keep singing. Good night, everyone.